Hi, I'm Gary. Data analysts, or anyone working with data, researchers, business analysts, and so on, will need to clean their data at some time or prepare their data for analysis. Now, what is that? What does it mean to clean your data or prepare your data for analysis? Well, unfortunately, there's no one single answer. There are many ways this can be done, and it really does depend on your objective, what you want to get out of the data, and also what the data looks like. Is it different languages, for example? Is it lots of different numbers and different fields that you need to combine, and so on? But in this short tutorial, I'll demonstrate some of the more common means that I use of cleaning data when I'm dealing with textual data. I'll go across to my screen. We're going to use a Python library called Pandas and also one called NLTK. Pandas is very good when working with data frames, and I'm sure if you've worked with textual data and Python before, you would have seen Pandas. Now, if you haven't worked with Python, don't worry. I'll put a link to where you can watch a video on how to install Python and how to use it. It's relatively simple and hugely powerful. NLTK has a lot of things we need to do with textual data or natural language programming. Of course, there are many other products or libraries in Python that you can use, GenSim, scikit-learn, and many others, but I'm just today using NLTK to demonstrate. So I've put the various things we're going to do in a Jupyter notebook. Now, this code I will add to a web page, and I'll in the description of this video, I'll put a link there so you can go and get this video for yourself. So just watch for now. Now, please like this video if you do enjoy it or you find it useful. Also, please subscribe to my channel. I'd really appreciate it. So the first thing is I've got a file of 1,000 rows of data. Let's just go and look at that. Now, this is a fairly small data set, but that's fine for these purposes. I'll open that up very quickly just so we can get a feel for what's going on. Okay, so there are two columns, a date column and something called title self text. And there are various things going on, lots of funny characters, all sorts of stuff going on. So this is very typical. Now, this data is from Reddit. This is 1,000 Reddit posts. So we're going to have different languages. It's going to be all over the place, lots of different spelling and so on. So there's a bit of work to do here before, for example, we could do topic modeling or anything like that with this data. I'll just get rid of that for now. So back to actually working with the data itself. Find the right thing to go to. Okay, so let's load this up and let's just look at it. So I'm loading up Pandas there, loading up that file, and let's just look at this. So, okay, so there are 1,000 entries or 1,000 rows of data, two columns, a date and a title, one term title self text, and that's exactly what we saw. Okay, nice and easy. Let's just look at a few of those. Doing df.head, we can look at the first 10 rows. Okay, so there they are. We've got different things going on. I don't know what that word is even. So that's very typical. A lot of sort of stuff going on here. Okay, that's absolutely fine. Okay, so two words even separated there. Okay, so there's a lot of work to do. Right, the first thing we're going to do, even though this looks as though it's in lowercase already, we'll make it all lowercase. This is hugely important because you then don't have to worry about titles or the casing, sorry, of text. So for example, if you're doing a find and replace, what you might find, depending on what tool, what library you're using and so on, it might be case sensitive or it might not. At least if we're putting all our text, all our letters down to lower, we don't have to worry. We always just use, for example, for a find and replace, lowercase characters. So let's just do that. And Pandas is very, very quick. Python is. Look at the first 10 rows again. Yep, all looking good, all lowercase. The next thing I'm going to do is remove white spaces. And I actually do that twice in this. I just like getting in the habit of that, just getting rid of those extra white spaces that you don't need, particularly when you're dealing with, for example, social media data, Facebook, Twitter, etc. You will need to get rid of additional white spaces. And again, we just have a summary of our data there. We're now going to tokenize our data. So we're importing or we're loading up NLTK. And what tokenizing is it breaks, or first of all, it converts into a list. It create we got strings at the moment. It converts it into a list, and let's just not worry about that too much. But what it does is it then breaks up each word into a single entity, or each part of a word as deemed relevant into a single entity. So then we can perform further functions on each word itself. And this is something, tokenizing, that we generally need to do with NLP, natural language programming, is break it down into words rather than just a string of letters. So let's do that. So you'll notice here, it's just a string as it looks there, but let's run that tokenization. I'll just run that quickly. There we go. Okay, it'll just take a few seconds to run. There we go. It's just downloading the package from NLTK. And there you can see, it's now put it, as you can see, everything is comma separated. Now, I'm using NLTK here to tokenize, but different means of tokenization do things slightly differently. So for example, NLTK, where here we had the word I'm, I hope you can see it, I comma apostrophe M, it's broken it down into two words. So again, as I said right at the beginning, this whole thing about cleaning your data or preparing it, it really does take some knowledge and some playing to find the best way of doing it. But that's fine. Okay, so I'm happy with this. As you can see, each word and each sort of entity is separated by a comma, so that's looking good. Let's now remove stop words. This is very, very common when dealing with data, particularly when we're doing things like topic modeling, maybe latent dirichlet allocation, LDA, topic modeling, and so on. We might be looking for the most common or not common or, okay, let's just use that term, common or frequently used words and so on. The problem is, if we have words that are meaningless for our data analysis, we're wasting our time. So let's remove them out of this data set so we can really analyze words that mean something. So for example, I'm might mean nothing, or you know, I am, or you know, the, or also might mean nothing. I'm actually going to use two means here. I'm using the NLTK stop words. I'll remove those. NLTK, and you can look this up on Google, they have a whole list of stop words that they keep updated. So I'll automatically remove all the stop words, and these are the very commonly used stop words that people remove from their data doing textual data analysis. Sorry, there we go. The other thing I'm doing is I've actually created a custom stop words file. I don't often see this, funny enough, but I think it's hugely, hugely important. Just to remove those extra words out of your data that you know aren't meaningful. And I'll show you the file. So that's custom stopwords.csv. So let's go to that. It's that custom stopwords.csv. I opened it up earlier, and you can see I've just added a whole lot of words in here. You know, between, should, through, people, very. I just know that I don't need those words. And at any time I could run this again and just remove, you know, add additional stop words and remove them. So let's go back to our script. So let's do that. Let's just run those, remove those stop words. It's pretty quick. So, okay. So what you'll notice is that's quite interesting. So if I just go up, sorry, there's a little bit of scrolling here, but that first word I, it's now removed. So if I go down, you'll see that that's been removed, and all those other words that are the NLTK and my custom stop words have now been removed. So we've still got some pretty strange words and so on, but let's carry on. Right, we're now going to remove punctuation. So for example, you can see here there's there are a few just different apostrophes and so on, and these are meaningless for my look, these are little, you know, these things are meaningless for my data analysis. So I'll just remove those quickly. I'll run that and it removes them, and you'll notice that it's gone from there, for example. So that's all good. Just carrying on. What we're going to do now is we're going to lemmatize. So we're going to find the lemma of each word. Again, the problem with analyzing textual data is a word might have various different spellings. It might even have different sort of go or going. It actually means the same thing for our analysis purposes, but people might write it differently. So therefore, we lemmatize, very standard task in NLP setup. We'll lemmatize that, so let's just run that. Okay, this will just take a few seconds to do. It is fairly slow. Although our corpus isn't that big, it does take a little while. It's a lot of work. for it to do. It needs to go for every single word and say, okay, does this word have a lemma? The base word of it. Okay, so that's run already. That was pretty quick, actually. Let's just see what we got here. Just very quickly looking through. Yeah, okay, we're looking okay. We still have various sort of stray little characters and so on, don't we? So now what we're going to do, because when we tokenized, the string was converted to a list, we now need to convert back to a string. So let's do that. And you'll notice it's not comma separate anymore. It's just in a string. Now, just some basic tidy up. What I'm going to do in this case is I'm going to remove all words that are three characters or less, because I've deemed that, I just think anyway, they're probably meaningless for my task at the moment, such as N, such as T, it'll remove that. You know, any other words that are just old, it'll remove that because it's less than three characters. If you need to remove characters, let's say four and less, you could change that to a four. But I'll just leave it at three for now. So let's do that. And I'm going to remove the white spaces again. I mentioned earlier that I do that a few times. Okay, you'll notice now that I don't have those stray one-word characters and so on anymore. Last but not least, for my purposes anyway, I'm now going to just save this. And let's just call this combined 1000 clean 2. So let's just save that. And let's just go and look at that file. It's nice and quick. Let's just open that up and just see what we're looking at. Okay, there we go. So now I don't have those four character words anymore. I've got the lemmas of the words and so on. So it's looking pretty good. Now I could always go and do more cleaning of the data. I could rerun these tasks if I needed to, maybe change the stop words. But once again, when you're cleaning your data, working with your data, preparing your data for textual analysis, there's no one way of doing it. You need to do it depending on what your aims are. But I certainly hope that this has helped. Please like this video and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.